What's up, y'all? It's Eric here. I'm about to do a pretty heavy upper body workout. So anytime I put my shoulders through any serious work, I like to warm up my rotator cuff muscles. Now, your rotator cuff muscles, these really small muscles, your subscapularis, your supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor, are four really small muscles that are commonly injured. The most common shoulder injuries, in fact, through athletes and lifters. So, before I get started with any serious shoulder work, I always make sure I do at least one round hitting my rotator cuff muscle from all those different angles. So usually starting with my subscapularis. Doing about 15 reps, making sure that I'm keeping the time under tension on the target muscle. And I'll flip around, hitting the teres minor. While in this position, I'll go ahead and switch hands. Now, as you're doing these rotator cuff muscles, it's really important to make sure that your shoulders and back are in a neutral position. You have your scapulothoracic articulation engaged in a neutral position, meaning your chest is open and your shoulders are not caved in on themselves. So after I do those, so I'll hit the upward rotation in order to hit my supraspinatus. Making sure that you get a full 90 degree rotation on this exercise while keeping your elbow parallel to your shoulder and pivoting on the elbow. After doing all three, other three rotator cuff muscles, the final one, you pull the cable up to the very top so you can, once again, pivot on the elbow in that 90 degree rotation. And your infraspinatus. So, it's Eric here. I'm about to do a few exercises with the kettlebell. The reason I like this exercise or this piece of equipment is because this exercise allows you to get your total body workout in. Once again, it allows you to get your resistance training at the same time you're getting some cardio in. That way you're getting as much results out of your work as possible. So, anytime there's stability, that means you have to keep your core engaged. So, there are several different kettlebell exercises, starting from the most basic to just kind of isolate your glutes, which all you're going to do is using the forward hip thrusting momentum of your glutes. Make sure you squeeze your glutes and drive your hips forward to generate enough momentum to move the kettlebell. Now, I can deepen this to get my posterior chain more involved by getting a squat. Notice that naturally, I can generate a little bit more momentum. Now, my favorite way to use this exercise is to get total explosiveness out of the exercise. So you're essentially exploding up as hard as you can, while at the same time keeping the kettlebell grounded to prevent from coming all the way up, which is a different exercise in itself. It's Eric here. So the next exercise I'm about to do with the kettlebell are snatches. Now, I really like this exercise because once again, it allows you to work on your explosiveness. But once again, giving you the opportunity to challenge your stabilizers as well. So I'm gonna get my glutes low, straight, strong core, keeping my chest up so that I know I'm getting enough explosion for my glutes as well as my quads. I'm going to drive this kettlebell up in a window pane-like movement and try to catch it at the top, stabilizing it at the top and returning it back down. The same movement, always exhaling through the effort. And you always want to make sure, for the sake of muscle imbalances, anything you do on one side, you do on the other. So it's Eric here. Next, I'm going to do lunges. Now, I'm going to choose to use the kettlebells because I have them handy. Remember, you can always do this exercise with dumbbells or even with a barbell on your back. So I am going to now do four different types of lunges. I'm going to do lunges to the front, back, side, as well as in the transverse plane. Now, as you are doing, I'm going to explain each lunge as I go through it. As you're doing the front lunge, a general mistake a lot of people have is shifting their weight forward. So whenever you're doing a front lunge, you want to keep your weight centered so you can come back stabilizing through that back, feeling the resistance to that back quad on the way down. Back lunge being the opposite in every respect, slightly leaning forward and almost reaching that back leg back as opposed to kind of stepping back. On the side lunges, in order to hit your glute medius, you want to come out to the side, getting your glutes back, shifting hips back, not overstepping out too far to the side. Now the transverse lunge being the most important lunge. Now, most ACL injuries happen because people are not expecting a turn on their knee. Now, if you're mentally anticipating movement, you're much less likely to get injured by it. Now, the more you practice a particular movement in a controlled environment, the much more likely your body will respond in that same way in an uncontrolled environment. So, as I'm doing these transverse lunges, the most important part of this is making sure as I rotate, I get a full rotation on my pivot foot before I come down in the lunge in order to protect the integrity of my knee. So it's a front lunge, so you're keeping your weight straight down and back, but with a rotation, making sure that you fully rotate that back foot before you come down in the lunge. Eric here, so next we're gonna be doing some wide grip rows. Now this exercise is really important because this is working the upper back, the posterior part, your rear delts, your mid traps, and your rhomboids. This is gonna help with that rounded forward lean that a lot of people experience. So first I'm gonna put one foot up here to brace myself, squeeze and engage my core so I don't hurt my back as I'm pulling this weight out. Come back up, try to get a 90 degree angle up the hips. And without having my shoulders shoot up to my ear, I'm gonna pull this bar straight back to the bottom of my rib cage, exhaling as I squeeze. So Eric here, next I'm gonna do some pull downs. Now there's two main grips that you can do with this. There's a wide grip and a reverse close grip, each of them hitting your lats in a different way. First one is the wide grip, which is going to be working on the width of the lats. So for most of the way down, it's working on the width of the lats. In the very last second, you're going to draw it back to the top of your sternum to get your scapular thoracic articulation secure and engaged. So I'm going to grab the handles as wide as I can, get as much width as possible, make sure I'm seeing people in my traps, disengage as I'm doing this exercise. So I'm going to slightly back and pulling straight down to my sternum. Now the other exercise, the reverse close grip, is going to be working on the thickness of the lats. And you know that you've gotten the full range of motion once you get your wrist to your rib cage and your elbows past your back. So this time you're going to grab the hand shoulder width apart with a reverse grip. So you're keeping your shoulders down so you can keep the tension in the target muscle being your lats. So, ERIK here, I'm gonna use a medicine ball exercise. Now, most people, they're usually working their rectus abdominis, their show muscles, their six pack. Now, I'm gonna do a Roman twist. You may have seen this exercise before. This one's really important because it's gonna work on our transverse abdominis, which comes across our core, one of our intrinsic core muscles. So, what I'm gonna do, you can do this with the feet down for modification, but I'm gonna keep my feet up for added stabilization. Remember, anytime you can have more stabilization, that means you've got more core. Now, it's really important to make sure that as you're doing this, you're not just moving your arms, but you're actually getting your torso to twist rather than just moving your arms. Now, also, you wanna make sure that you're keeping your head in line with your body. This is gonna ensure that you're getting your actual torso to twist as opposed to just moving, once again, your arms across your body. So, if, say, getting on the ground is a little challenging for you, another way to do the Roman twist is by standing up. Now, as you're doing this, it's really important to make sure that you don't over-rotate your torso back past your hips, therefore putting excessive strain on your back and knees. So if you're going to do this modified Roman twist with your feet planted into the ground, you need to make sure that you're controlling the rotation to the width of your shoulders. ERIK here, so I'm going to show you another exercise you can do with the medicine ball. So this exercise, preferably done with the soft medicine ball as opposed to a hard bouncier one, will add a little bit more difficulty. So what I'm going to do are medicine ball slams. I'm going to bring this medicine ball straight up above my head, keeping my arms as straight as possible, and using my entire body weight to slam it into the ground, making sure that you don't hit that crease on it, making it bounce in some weird direction. So it's important to make sure that you're keeping your arms straight so you're getting your lats involved in the slam as opposed to a tricep extension by bending your arms.